Now we need to work on our orders form, which is the most crucial of our forms. It's where we'll have our database user, the store employee, identify what book or books are being ordered by which customer. Now we already have the basic form set up. It was created just like our other forms. It shows all the fields that are in the orders table, and it is currently showing the first record in the orders table. The setup of this form isn't very useful to someone who is entering orders. All of these IDs really don't mean much to the person taking a new order. The only thing a person entering data would care about is the customer name and the book title. In other words, who ordered what? Now, as our database owner, we want to restrict the use of the form to only entering new records so that the person using the form doesn't accidentally overwrite an existing order. We want it to open to the new record each time. So let's set up that level of control right now. First, let's rename the form New Orders so our user can tell at first glance that he or she should be entering only new orders. To make it so that records can only be added, we have to set the form properties. You can do that in Design View. If the property sheet is not already open, click on the Property Sheet command in the Tools group under the Design tab. Now make sure Form is selected from the drop-down since that's where we want to make our changes. Now we'll set a few options under the Data tab. The text in the lower left corner of the window helps you know what each field property does. So if we click in Data Entry, we know it is asking you if you want to only allow new records to be added. So we'll change No to Yes. We want to be able to allow additions, so this will remain Yes. Now we don't want to allow deletions, so we'll set that to No. And we also don't want our user to edit data from the orders form, so we'll set that to no. Now we have a form for our employee to enter new orders. So now let's look at this form from our user's point of view. How would he or she want to use it when a customer brings a book to purchase or order? Now you see the default view for entering new orders. Let's quickly dissect this form. Order ID is just the unique number that the database assigns to each order. This isn't an editable field, and it isn't something the user would ever need to touch, so we'll hide the order ID. To do that, switch to Design View. Highlight the field box and its label. Bring up the property sheet for these boxes if it's not already open. Under the Format tab, select No beside Visible. Now I'll switch back to Form View so you can see that the Order ID field is hidden. Next, we see Customer ID and Book ID. They obviously aren't very usable like they are now, but we'll come back to those in a minute. Let's consider the Order Date field. As a database owner, we want the date to default to the current date since no customer will place an order for any other day than today, and we would want that information in our table, but the person entering the new order wouldn't need to enter that. So to set that up, go to Design View, highlight the field box, and bring up its property sheet if it's not already open. We want to double-check and make sure the drop-down is set to Order Date. From the Data tab, we want to make sure the default value is set up to always enter the current date. We'll use the expression builder to enter this function. The function starts with an equal sign, so I'll go ahead and click equals. Next, we need to click the Common Expressions folder in the first column. In the center column, we'll click on Current Date. In the third column, we'll click on Date. All this equation really means is that we want this field to always automatically enter the current order date. We're finished with the Data tab, so let's go to the Format tab to hide this field too, since we're automatically putting today's date in. Let's take a look at the form in Form View. Now our form user just has to worry about getting the right customer ID and the right book ID, but the ID numbers don't help them very much as they are, since they'll be dealing with a real person with a real book and not a customer ID with a book ID. To make sure our user enters the correct customer, we would want him to choose from our list of customers. But we want the database to store the customer ID number and not the name, since that is a unique identifier for a customer. Well, with the combo box control, we can put all the information our user needs right on the new order form itself. This box will let them choose the customer based on a list of the customer names that appear in our customers table. And we can set the form controls up so that once our user picks a customer from the list, the customer ID is stored in the orders table. Let's do this now. Since we're using a combo box, I really don't need this text box or label anymore, so I'll delete it. Next, we'll click on the combo box command in the controls group. Then we'll move our cursor over our form until we see a crosshair with a combo box icon. Now we're going to draw the combo box. From the wizard, we'll choose the first option. By choosing this option, we're telling Access to find what we want the user to see in the combo box. Now we need it to look in the customers table. And we need all the fields so that our form user can see a complete record in order to figure out which customer he needs to enter. We want it to sort alphabetically by last name, since that is the logical way for our user to look up a customer. Here we can set the column width so that it all looks nicely compact on our form. Double-click the column edges to get it to best fit. We also have to move the last name column over to the left so that we see the last name listed first in the drop-down list. Next, we want to tell Access to store the data, so we'll select the second option. This option is asking which value from the orders table we want stored in the orders table, and we want to store our customer's ID number, so select customer ID from this list. This is the label for the combo box. We'll type in customer here. Well, it looks like we're finished here. We'll go to Form View to take a look. If you want, you can move the label and the combo box, but we'll take a look at formatting in our next lesson. Now we're going to do the same thing for book ID. Our form user isn't going to know the book ID of the book, so we'll want him to be able to search on the book title and author. I'll go ahead and finish this up really quickly. One more enhancement that would make this form more usable is to add a button so that when our form user enters a new record, they can hit this button to save the record to the orders table and advance to the next new record. Here's how you do that. Click Button on the controls portion of the ribbon. Move your mouse over the form until the crosshair with the button icon appears. Draw your button wherever you want it to appear on the form. You can always move this button later. When our button is pushed, we want it to save the current record and advance to a new record. So from the categories list, we'll select Record Navigation, and from the action list, we'll select Go to Next Record. The next screen lets us decide whether or not we want text or a picture on the button. I want the text to read Submit because that's what we generally see on forms where we have to enter and send information. Now, once a user clicks Submit, the information will be saved to the orders table. Also, by hitting Submit, we advance to the next blank record. On the next screen, we can choose to give this button a special name. This could be handy if you have several buttons and you need to know which is which if you ever have to edit the buttons later. I'll type in Submit here. Let's go back to Form View and test out our new form. So now, if Jimmy Smith purchases Computer Basics, it will be much easier to enter and save the new record to our orders table. As I said before, by clicking Submit, Access automatically saves the record to the table, but you may have to click Refresh All in the orders table to see the change. So you've learned how to make forms really user-friendly by adding command buttons and setting form properties. In our next lesson, we'll learn how to make this form look good.